when I got the call. Yeah, I just collapsed to the floor.
Bro, I think X got shot, bro. I think X got shot, bro. I think X got shot, bro. I think X got shot.
I'm like, they did what? And what do you mean they shot? That's it.
I remember not having any gas, not wanting to stop, trying to get to where he was, and it's all a blur.
And I just remember, like, calling Cleo. Like, Cleo, where are you? She's like, I'm lost. She, like, literally didn't know where she was. I'm like, bro, you gotta get somewhere. We're at the hospital. She's like, I'm trying to get there. And she's like, I don't know where I'm at.
I was, like, disoriented. I got there. There was a few people there already. I'm not sure how they found out. And I was just in there for mad long, pacing back and forth. I wasn't able to go back there. They gave me some bullshit story about them not wanting me to see him like that because it would traumatize me. But I think that I should have made that decision of seeing my son.
And then it's like that calm, just it was like a calm that set in because it's like, all right, it's Jesse. He's already like, he's a fighter. He's a fighter. Jesse's gonna make it through. Nobody's gonna make it through. It's gonna be him.
The cops came out and they pulled me in the room. And I remember the officer was just so callous when he delivered. He was just like, oh, Jesse expired today at such and such time.
I still don't understand what he means by expired.
That shit just seemed like watching a movie or something. I don't know. I'll never come to terms with it.
It went from that to just planning a funeral. I remember Cleo walking in the room and saying, how do we plan a funeral? How do I plan a funeral for my son?
Boy, lay me down to sleep. Pray the Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too late for me. Down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too late for me. Difference changing in the distance, time consumes the image. Before I lay me down to sleep, pray the Lord my soul to keep. Hope's not too late for me.